बुद्धि विलासाय दीपज्योति नमो।
Respected Dr. Pankaj Joshi, the head healthcare services of the Adani Group. Respected Dr. Gyanesha Rao, the medical director. Respected Dr. Nagarjan Bhadarkar, the medical superintendent. And we are fortunate today to have among us Shri V.S. Gadvi, the IAS and director of the Adani Foundation. He is at present chief of the administrative services across GAIMS and GK General Hospital. Welcome, sir. My dear professors, fellow colleagues, dear Dr. Chardul Chaurasia, the manager, administration, Dr. Chintan Chanishwara, administration team head, dear parents, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. I extend a hearty and warm welcome to you all. Abhinandan, Swagatam, Khush Aamdeed. Dear students and to the parents, you are all welcome in the hallowed precincts of the GAIMS on this occasion of the White Coat ceremony and inaugural function. The new day begins for the students today. It is indeed a glorious moment for the parents whose wards have succeeded in getting admission by their sheer hard work in this prestigious institute of Western Gujarat, the Gujarat Adani Institute of Medical Sciences. We fondly call it as the GAIMS. Emerging from the ashes of the earthquake, and with the wholehearted support of late Shri Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, the GAIMS and its associated GK General Hospital are growing in leaps and bounds. If you look at slide, is a big structure coming up now with UG and postgraduate studies. Now I'll talk about medical profession. If you look at slide 4, Kaschid Dharm, Kaschid Maitri, Kaschid Arth, Kaschid Yash, Kramabhyasam, Kaschid Sheti, Chikitsa Nasti, Nishphala. I'll convert it into Hindi. Rogiyon ki seva, chikitsa se, kuch dharm, kuch mitra, kuch paisa, aur kuch yes milta hai. Chikitsa kabhi nishfal nahi hoti hai. Agar ye sab na bhi mile, to chikitsak ka abhyas to ho hi jata hai. So it is a win-win situation. Medical education is a win-win situation. This is the only profession where seva and meva are got together. My dear students, the White Coat ceremony, which is likely to occur soon, does not mean just wearing a white coat as a symbolic. No, it is much more than that. It is your entry into medical profession. And a professional is one who habitually uses quality attributes in day-to-day practice. And these attributes are knowledge, skills, ethics, compassion, and communication. Therefore, these attributes have to be learned during your undergraduate and subsequently postgraduate training program. Medical profession is labor-intensive. It requires hard work. Even after 10 plus 2, a continuum lifelong learning is required to be updated and be an effective practitioner, consultant, doctor, and teacher. Therefore, I will yearn upon you all to to continue learning from the senior professors, from the faculty, and from the respected patients who are the sources of information to all of us. Swami Vivekananda said, it's a very famous, can it change? No, you can do it. Harmonious development of the head, the heart and hands is the mark of a model man. I'll repeat, harmonious development of head, the heart and hands is the mark of a model man. By hands I mean skills. By head I mean knowledge. And by heart I mean attitude, compassion. Therefore all these three, when go together, it becomes a model man. And who is a model man today? A doctor. So all the three attributes are developed in a doctor. During your training, dear students, you will learn a lot about the several competencies which are in these three domains. We say psychomotor domain, the knowledge component, the activity component. And there are large number of activities pertaining to each one of them. You will learn a lot about structure. You will learn a lot about function of a normal body, alteration in the structure and function of the body. Then you will also learn about the effect of drugs on the body. And finally, you will also gain insight about the diagnosis of the diseases by clinical and lab examinations, and will also be able to use medicines to treat the sick. And entire process is 4.5 years plus 1 year training as internship training. In order to impart this type of training, the GAIMS is equipped with all the possible modern teaching learning tools and the equipments, laboratory equipments, to provide you quality education. At present, we promote e-learning to make learning a pleasurable and interactive teaching. We use modern techniques to impart the education. Not only just audiovisual presentation which you are seeing, much more than that actually. For example, I tell you, we now have live demonstrations of surgeries being done in the operation theater, which are displayed into the classrooms and lecture halls for learning experience as an interactive learner. We also have a simulation lab, a small simulation lab for postgraduates to learn new things on the what we call as mannequins or dummies. Now this, let me talk about this institution. We have 150 intake MBBS students who are present here. We also have a diploma course in medical laboratory technician, 30 intakes per year. And we have postgraduate courses in 15 clinical, preclinical and paraclinical subjects, with total intake approved by MCI 51. And at present, 41 postgraduates have come as a R1 resident this year. Now, several differentiation distinctions are there. There are MD courses, there are MS courses in different subjects with total 51 intake. Therefore, you will appreciate that GAIMS is fully fledged to impart training to undergraduate and postgraduate students, and this training is quality education. Believe me, you compare the way it is we are doing the teaching here with any standard across India, you will find it is as good. We are also running a DMLT program, and first batch is rolled out this month. We are awaiting result. The next batch has also been admitted, and they will begin their session on 1st September this year. Now, let me give you some report on the academic activities. We our undergraduate and postgraduate students have excelled in all fields, the curricular fields, the extracurricular and co-curricular activities. My UG students have performed extremely well. Now let us look at the report. The result of 17-18, the first MBBS, second MBBS, final MBBS, the pass percentage is over 90%. And we had 6 distinctions, first MBBS, regular batch, and 5 distinctions in second MBBS, and 1 distinction in the final MBBS examination. Even in the remanded batch, the remaining students, they have also done very well. And the pass percentage was 94% in the last examination in the April-May this year. Therefore, you can always say that despite all the university regulations and following norms, our students are performing very well. You can also look at the performance is consistent across the years. And rather we are improving now. The number of the distinctions are increasing when we go up. That is important to note. So far as selections in the pre-PG NEET examinations, it is really remarkable. There is a slide. NEET pre-PG. Yes. Last year we had 90 students in the NEET pre-PG list and total 57 got postgraduate training, postgraduate studies in various schools. But you look at now present today's arena and you find 178 students of this institution were enlisted in NEET pre-PG examination. And out of these 178, 68 got admission in various postgraduate courses across India. Out of these 68, 17 were my students and they are here as postgraduates. So it is very heartening to know that yes, GAIMS is progressing. Now let us talk of something about co-curricular activities. We received 5 ICMR STC student awards last year. And one of the students was identified internationally as Kidney Star and he took training in America. Among other students, this is Dr. Purvangi Thakkar, postgraduate in gynecology, and she bagged first position in poster presentation in All India Conference at Ahmedabad. Dr. Rishi Patel, another postgraduate from ISKCON. Dr. Dhoni Mehta from gynecology. Next. And among the undergraduates, Kavita Chhaya of this 2015 batch, she was recipient of the Bal Shri Samman from the minister. Next. They have made us proud. So these are the students they win at many places. Shreya. Next. We are taking part in various co-curricular activities, extracurricular activities also. Next, please. Now, Speaker of Kutch University, one of our students, Maulik Rajendrabhai Patel and Dishi Gandhi, were announced, declared as Speaker of the Kutch University. Next, please. Table tennis. In table tennis at district level, our student stood at forefront. Next, and look at other activities, Youth Festival 2017, a large number of students participated and bagged several awards in different sports and games. This time also, we are sending a big contingency for the same activity, and I expect that they will also bring laurels to the institution. Next. Again, same TT Inter College. Now, this is extracurricular activity which our students do. It is just a gist, an example. There are many such. 33 students of this college went for Seva Yatra a few days back for 3 days to treat the sick in the remote areas of Dahod under NMO. Next. And the game, gem of the games today is, next, Priyanka Bhatt, 7th semester student. She stood first in all India Osmecon conference for the undergraduates at Hyderabad recently. So she has brought a name to this institution. This is a Lilliput girl, but with big brains actually. So all the congratulations to Priyanka Bhatt. Next. And this is the prize she has got. Wait, go back. She has stood first in this conference. She has faced a large number of audience like this, faced the professors and their question answers also, and bagged the prize. Next. Now, see, the students perform when faculty is good. Only then these things happen. And look at the performance of faculty. My faculty members, they write chapters in the books, they write books, they also write reviews, they are invited as guests at various fora, and they are honored. Next, please. Next, please. Dr. Lanjavar, is he here? Dr. Lanjavar has been honored internationally several times last year, and then this year also he has been acknowledged there. Now, this institution believes in using modern technologies, and most of the credit was go to Dr. Gyaneshwar Rao, who is medical director. Now, e-learning initiatives initiated by him are also co-worked by Dr. R.N. Prasad, who is professor and head of the Department of Anesthesiology. And he regularly prepares small videos, educational videos, and uploads it on the YouTube. Anybody can use it. So this is promotion of the learning, e-learning actually. And a similar note, Dr. Naidu, who has recently joined, he's a professor of physiology, and is extremely savvy about programming actually. And he's trying to convert entire program of physiology and first MBBS subjects into e-learning modules actually. So very soon we may have a very different way of learning. Then Dr. Hitesh, wait. Dr. Hitesh Asudari has done a e-learning course. Dr. Jitendra Patel has prepared an Android app for physiology learning. And Dr. Ajit Kildani is also using several times interactive sessions for undergraduate students. They are off the working hours actually. Next. Apart from that, unless we learn, we cannot teach effectively. So we are still learning. And the way we are learning is Dr. Hitesh Azudani, International Framework Course. 3 faculty members have completed. I am Medical Council of India Faculty Development Course, called as ACME. And Dr. Amit Maheshwari has completed PG Diploma in Hospital Management, Quality Management. And 2 young persons, Dr. Gurudas Kilnani and Dr. Gyaneshwar Rao. Are still studying ACME. So we are students at present for this course. Next, please. And I am really thankful to my faculty. They have really contributed. I will not be taking the names of several ones, but to mention a few, I will be grateful and thankful to Dr. Nimish Pandya. Not only is he an expert consultant, experienced consultant, but he has actually contributed a lot in postgraduate education today. And most of the awards are in his department actually. So big my dear students, coming in the class for attendance serves very little purpose. Believe me, attendance isn't only the reason you must be present in the class. You may be there to experience the unteachable elements of the medicine. We called it as hidden curriculum. Something not written, but something necessary to learn. And it is that hidden curriculum that comes in the form of interaction. It comes in the form of how fellow colleagues are learning. So it is an indirect learning. For this, we have to be in the class. And therefore, unteachable elements of the medicine that you will encounter day after day. It is those million undefinable moments in this blessed journey that will shape the doctor that you will become. I urge upon you, so be there every day, you lucky, lucky fellows. Next, please. I yearn upon you to be regular in the class, learn as much as from the learned faculty, and we also try our level best to improvise and update in imparting quality education to you. Now, in the last, I am grateful to Dr. Malay Mahadeviya, Dr. Pankaj Doshi, Shri Gadvi, Dr. Rao, and all other fellow colleagues who have been contributing in the journey called as the GAIMS. Thank you all very much. In the last, thanks all the dignitaries for sparing time from their busy schedules and blessing my students and us. Jai Gadvi Gujarat, Jai Hind. Thank you.